Today we're going to be talking about the Progressive Era. Hoover calls the Gilded Age. Excellent. This is a sack from the Gilded Age. It is sweaty, it is smelly. Why so? Immigration, urbanization, unsanitary working conditions, poor eating conditions. It is a sweaty, stinky mess of society. People were sick of this sweaty, smelly sack of society. So what did they do? They took the shape, this form of a sack, and they reworked it. They reformed it. They worked with other people in their society to create a whole new shape, a whole new form into the progressive person. Okay, so this concept of reform is going to be woven through the Progressive Era. Remember, the sweaty sweat sack of the Gilded Age is going to be reshaped and reformed into a society for progressive people. It's a basic cause and effect. Too many people, poor living conditions, and poor working conditions are going to cause a yearning for change. Shaping or reforming of the sweaty sweat sack of the Gilded Age are going to be initiated by religious groups, members of the press, authors, and political groups. These progressive people and groups wanted to stop corrupt government and help the poor in the both living and working conditions. Let's check on learning. A major goal of reformers during the Progressive Era was to 1. End segregation in the South, 2. Correct the abuses of big business, 3. Limit immigration from Latin America, 4. Enact high tariffs to help domestic industry grow. If you chose number 2, correct the abuses of big business, you are right. Now let's move on. Now what does 3 levels of this concept of reform actually mean? At the local level, you have social reformers. They were the individuals who were squeezing and molding the dough of society in hopes for a positive reform or change. These social reformers wanted better living conditions for the poor, family planning education, and racial and gender equality at both the local and national levels. Examples of social reformers are Jane Addams, who established the settlement house Hull House, and Margaret Sanger, who founded the organization that would become Planned Parenthood. Remember that there are 3 levels of reform in the Progressive Era: local, state, and national. We've talked about social reformers Jane Addams. Now let's look at state reforms. Governors of New York, Wisconsin, and New Jersey helped pass political reforms in their respective states. The 3 major political reforms, initiative, referendum, and recall, were ways that people, you and me, could directly affect legislation of the government. Initiative, let the people tell the legislation the citizens actually wanted, like initiate. Referendum sounds like referee. It's where the actual voters decided if a law should be passed. They're kind of in the middle negotiating. Recall, it's like returning a bad politician. It's when voters petition to have officials removed from office. Initiative, referendum, and recall are 3 state political reforms where the people molded and reformed society so that they could prevent corruption of the government and increase their participation. Let's check on learning. Democratic reforms such as the initiative and the referendum were 1. Guaranteed government jobs for the unemployed during the progressive movement. 2. Create a unicameral national legislature during the progressive movement. 3. Increase the participation of African Americans in the federal government. Or 4. An important political aim of the progressive movement was. If you chose 4, important and political aim, you are correct. Now let's move on. While state reforms were passed in order to increase people's participation in government, federal reforms were passed in order to protect the health and safety of the American citizen, as with to improve economic regulations. Author authors who exposed the health and safety problems of industrialization were called muckrakers. Why the term muckrakers? Let's watch.
The progressive movement owed much to the writers and journalists known as muckrakers, a new and powerful voice for reform. Among their many contributions, nothing had a greater impact on public policy than Upton Sinclair's The Jungle, a staggering and nauseating description of the meatpacking industry.
There were cattle which had been fed on the refuse of the breweries and had become covered with boils. It was a nasty job killing these, for when you plunged your knife into them, they would burst and splash foul-smelling stuff into your face.
The passage of the Pure Food and Drug Act and the Meat Inspection Act is a great illustration of how progressivism succeeded because it was able to galvanize the American population as a whole.
I aimed at the public's heart, and by accident, I hit it in the stomach.
That power of publicity that the muckrakers beautifully mobilized was the way in which progressives got enough Americans focused on this issue that corporations that didn't want to change, powerful meat packers and others, drug companies that didn't want to have to give up their freedom, finally came to the conclusion that they better settle.
Most infamous muckrakers, Upton Sinclair, author of The Jungle, expose the sweaty sweat sack of the meatpacking industry. Upton Sinclair investigated dangerous working conditions and unsanitary procedures in the meatpacking industry. Because of his work, the American people were aware that the food they were eating was unsafe. The American people called for reform. The result? The passing of the federal reform, the Meat Inspection Act. So there you have it. The progressive era was a time when the sweaty sweat sack was out and the progressive person was in. Reform happened at three levels, the local, state, and federal. Social reformers like Jane Addams and her settlement house, and muckrakers like Upton Sinclair, who exposed the ills of the meatpacking industry, were progressives who sought change. The American people wanted increased participation, initiative, referendum, recall. They wanted healthy food, a safe place to work and live. During the progressive era, Americans threw off their sweaty sock, ready to work for progress and reform.